School Freeware's Visual Basic Express 2010 Tutorials, Tutorial 15, Multiple Window Forms. To add a Windows form to your project, click on Project, Add Windows Form. I'll select the Windows form from the templates. I'll keep form2.vb as the form's name, and I'll click on Add. And now I have two forms, Form 1 and Form 2, within my application. I'll go to Form 1, and I'll just resize a little bit, and I'll go ahead and add a label, and I'll go change the label's properties to state the text as Form 1, and the font to font size 25. I'll copy Ctrl-C and paste Ctrl-V into Form 2, and I'll change the label within Form 2 to state Form 2. When I go ahead and run, I get Form 1 pops up, but I don't have any way of opening up Form 2 at this time, so I'll just close down Form 1, and I'll add a button into Form 1. I'll change the text of this button to state Open Form 2, and I'll change the font size to font size 20. I'll double click on the button and put in the code form2.show. I'll go ahead and run and click on the button. Form 2 shows. And with .show, I can navigate between Form 1 and Form 2 simply by clicking on the forms. I'll close Form 1 down and Form 2. I'll go ahead and change the code form2.show to form2.showdialog. Go ahead, run. And with Form 2 opened as a dialog, I can move Form 2 around, work with it if I choose. But I cannot go back to Form 1 simply by clicking. I had to close Form 2 down, and now I can go ahead with Form 1. I'll go close Form 1 and work with some variables between the two forms. So I'll just go back to Show, and I'll click on Form 1, and I'll just copy and paste this label, and I'll just simply change the name of the label to Label Count. And the text will state count equals 0. I'll start that off as that. Click on the Form 1, go into the event and unload. And I'll go ahead and I'll put in public count as integer. Now I have the public set so I can call count from Form 2. So this is just creating a variable count. Instead of putting dim, I'll put in public. So therefore the code can be accessed from Form 2. So here within Form 1 load, I'll just initialize it to say count equals 0. And within Form 2, I'll just have a button to increment the count. So I'll put in a button. And I'll just put the text as add. And I'll make the font size 20. Double click on the button, and I'll just say form 1, because that's where count is, count plus equal 1. And I'll say form 1 dot label count dot text equals the string conversion of form1.count. So go ahead, run. Open up Form 2. Count now equals 0. Count equals 1, 2, 3, and so on. Close down Form 2. Close down Form 1. Now, if I wish to have Form 2 open up for any reason, I can go to Project and select the Properties. And you'll find the name of the application that you are working with before Properties. In this case, it's Visual Basic Tutorial 15. So I'll just go into the Properties, and here you find the Startup Form. Right now, I have it set to Form 1, but I can change to Form 2. And I'll go ahead and run, and now Form 2 shows up as the Startup Form. I'll close this down. And I'll just change back to Form 1. So now Form 1 is the default startup form.